So it's just you and me, you at home and me here in the fitness classroom. So it looks like the people who are normally here aren't here today, but I see that we do have some viewers online, so we're gonna keep it going, you know? I appreciate people being here. So we're gonna start out as we normally do. Hands together, going in circles. I need some form of like a green screen that I can put behind me so it looks more entertaining than an empty room. But empty room is what we have today. And then going backwards. The way I look at it is that if we had perfect workout conditions every day, if it was 60 degrees, partly cloudy, and a room full of people all the time, we'd never work out, because that's the only way we'd ever work out. Sometimes you're in a room by yourself. We're going to figure eights now. Sometimes that room by yourself is really hot. Sometimes it's dark. Sometimes it's too bright. Sometimes it's too windy. Sometimes a room's not a room at all. Maybe it's a gravel road in the middle of nowhere and you're running. But we're still here. That's what matters. We're still doing it. Very good. So what we're going to do now, we're going to put our hands together in front of us, and we're going to go out to the sides. So today's workout is pretty much all upper body and some core. Now you're going to take your palms, you're going to face them up, and you're just kind of raising the roof. So at the end of this, you just feel a lot of chest, a lot of arms, good for the core. Good. Now palms down. Last one we're going to go into is pushing back. Palms facing back. Pushing back. I appreciate the two of you being here right now. I appreciate anybody that's going to be watching this in the future. Very good. Man, my shoulders are already tired. We might just call it a day right there. So what we're going to do is we're going to cross our hands in front of our arms. Cross our arms in front of our chest. And then we're going just to go ahead and we're going to start doing those small circles. I think we did these last week. But we're just going to do small circles right at our hips. You can even get your knees into it. You can even start kind of wobbling around. We're just trying to limber up everything. Sometimes your workout, you're in a bad spot, going the other way now, and you're in an undesirable workout location. It'd be really easy just to cancel this class, but I need my workout too. So, as much as this is for each and every one of you, it's also for me. I just happen to be the one with the microphone. So, last thing we're going to do, and then we'll just start getting into it, is we're going to cross our leg over. We're going to go down to a squat. But as we do this, I want everybody to raise their hands out in front of them, go up and over, and then switch. As we finish up this workout, think about how much fun you had this weekend, or not fun. Had this weekend. I don't know. Depends on your position in life. And then just think about getting into this workout. Leave whatever it was behind. Be in the present moment. Be here with us. With me. I'm there with you. Just get ready to devote yourself to the next 25-ish minutes. So I'll get into demonstrations. We'll actually move this, since we don't have anybody else, and a lot of it's on the floor. You get a little bit more of a view now. We like views. So I got all the windows open. I like views too. So, from here, you're going to go down into the ground. Pretty much everything's going to be on the ground today. So, the first one is something that we have done before. So it's a shoulder tap. The big key here is to stay nice controlled. We want everything to be kind of like this the whole time. We don't want to see, even if you're up more, that is actually more okay. We just want to see it nice and controlled. You're down on your knees as well, nice and controlled. What we don't want to see is swaying of the hips or sagging. So you're here, you're just tapping that shoulder. You shift that weight onto one arm versus the other. You tap your shoulder. We don't want to see you like opening up and moving those hips too much. Everything should be nice and engaged. Squeezing those quads, squeezing those glutes, squeezing those abs. Everything's nice and engaged. Next one we're going to go into is a diamond push-up. So same exact principles. Everything's nice controlled. Your two options are either on your toes or on your knees. You can bring your knees either farther away or closer to make it easier or harder. But you're going to take your hands, you're going to put them in the shape of a diamond, you're going to put them on the ground, and you're just going to push up right there. You may not be able to go quite as low, as you noticed, like I couldn't go as low there, but everything is about squeezing straight to the chest, straight back out. Next one, we're going down onto our belly and onto our chest. These are called Superman extension. I don't care how far up you're getting, like I'm not trying to get you up like this. We just want to get that back engaged. So from here, your hands are straight or your arms are straight, your feet are straight and legs are straight. And then you're just lifting up, squeezing the glutes, squeezing the shoulder blades back and down, squeezing all through the back, even squeezing into the hamstrings. We just want everything in the back to be engaged. You come up, you hold for a second, you go back down, and then you just keep doing more reps of that. The next one, we're gonna do two sets of, so 30 seconds one side, 30 seconds the other side. You're going to be into a side plank, and then we're gonna open up out of that side plank. So there's a whole bunch of different versions of this. You can be down on your elbow, just on both knees, be down on your elbow, 1 foot out. You can be down your elbow, both feet, or you can be up like this. Whatever floats your boat, whatever makes sense for your ability level and your comfort for the day. The big one, you have to keep those hips forward. So I'll do it facing you. We want to have everything nice and in line. We don't want to see your hips falling backwards. So the big thing here is no matter what position you're in, you're holding those hips forward, you're squeezing those glutes, you're squeezing those abs, everything's forward. From here though, the opener part, you'll be up, touching the ground, coming up, opening all the way through. As you open, we want to see you kind of following that with your hand or with your eyes, so that way you're getting a full rotation, keeping everything forward, keeping everything squeezed, you're getting that full rotation all the way through. After 30 seconds, we'll switch over to the exact same thing, the opposite side. And the last one, this one's kind of awkward, but it is really hard. It just takes a second to get the coordination, but it's called a tricep kick, crab kick. So you're up like this, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna come down on your triceps, going up, kicking out, going down, kicking out. If you wanna make it harder, you can go down, come up on one leg, that, so you're kicking out at the bottom. That one's a little bit harder. If you need to make it a little easier, you're just doing your tricep extension. So you're just coming down, bringing those hips up and through. You just don't add the kick back there. The big thing with this is that we want to make sure those triceps are actually doing some work and we're not just like shrugging and unshrugging our shoulders. So we want the movement to be at our elbows, not at our shoulders. As always, do whatever makes sense for you. Do not think that if I'm doing something and you're not doing it, you're doing it wrong. whatever your body is able to do in the moment. I'll switch over our music, and we'll get going on our work right now. I'm turning up the music in here a little bit. I'm by myself. I need to fill the room.
All I need is a head full of hope and a love.
Go ahead and do the same if you want to. And I just realized my batteries are about to die. We're gonna have a problem. So I'm gonna go quiet for a second and then I'll be right back.
So throw your sticks and throw your stones, cause you ain't gonna break my bones. If
sure we're back. Oh, look at that. Golden. Alrighty. I'm done lying to you. We're actually going to get started here. Alrighty. On the ground. Get ready to start some shoulder taps. I'm doing 4 rounds of 30 seconds today. You got it. Same as usual. I am Mark. Get set. Go. Focus on that control. We're just tapping those shoulders. Back and forth. If you need to make it a little easier, go ahead and widen out those feet. If you want to make it a little harder, bring your feet together. I like to pick something right there in the middle, kind of in line with my hips and my shoulders. Stay in control. Straight into that diamond push-up. Bring those hands together. Going down. You're really having to use the back of the arms here. Like I said, it's okay if you can't go as deep. We want to see you, though, really getting that motion. If you aren't able to go very deep at all, maybe go down to your knees and you can go a little deeper. It's all about quality movement. Very good. Down onto your stomach. Give those wrists a break. Onto your stomach, hands out over your head, engaging everything on the back. Make sure you're squeezing everything on the back. As you come up, hold for a second, ease yourself back down. Make sure you're not just flopping back to the ground. Now everybody's favorite, right here, into that side plank. That works. Just opening all the way up. Keep the nose hips forward. If you're in a position like I am, 1 foot, one knee, make sure you're trying to stay balanced between the two. Make sure you're not just laying on your bottom knee. Very good. Switch on over. Make sure you're feeling it through your tummy. Make sure you're feeling it in your glutes. Very good. Into those tricep crab kicks. At the top, make sure you're squeezing those glutes again. Make sure you're not just arching your back to get up there. We're not trying to stick out our belly and get as high as we can. We want it to all come from the glutes and the core, not from the back. And take a break. Very good. Not having to do as many transitions, just staying on the ground makes it go quick. So I had to change my batteries in my microphone. But last night, I'm laying in bed, and all of a sudden around 11:30, the smoke detector decided to start going off. I live in a rental house, so I have absolutely no idea how to turn this thing off. Like, I took it down, changed the batteries, it says press the test button to reset. You press test button, doesn't work. So I'll have to play with that later. But why is it always the middle of the night? Like, why could it not do it at 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock while I'm eating dinner? Like, really? 11 o'clock, that's when you decide to go off? So, back on the ground. Dalton's story time is over. I'll tell you more about trials and tribulations in my life in a second. On your mark, get set, go. Controlled shoulder taps. Stay up, cause I'm then straight into that diamond push-up. Hands together, getting quality movement. Make sure you're getting enough movement so that way you're getting a good workout. Five more seconds. You got it. Very good. Back into that back extension. Make sure we're squeezing everything on the back. You should feel it squeezing from your calves all the way up through your shoulders. Moving down into your arms. Up into that side plank. Keeping those hips engaged even as you rotate down to touch the ground. Make sure your glutes are squeezed. Make sure that core is engaged. Very good. Switch over to the other side. Remember what that feeling was like on one side. And feel this side. Does that feel the same? Is one harder than the other? Try and make them both as easy as the easier side. Alrighty, thinking forward to those triceps. If you want to make it harder, you can scoot your feet out. Use more of your heels than your flat feet. Very good. Up into those crab walk position. You're up. If you want to make it harder, get your heels out. Using a little more hamstring here. We expect everybody at home to be working hard even when they're by themselves. Go big or go. Because it's proof we expect ourselves to do the same. Very good. And take a break. Halfway done. Get yourself a drink of water. We've only got two more rounds. We can squeeze it in before the kids are up. Before the spouse is walking out the door. For the dog needs to go out. We're up early getting our work in, so that way we have the freedom of the rest of the day.
Hey! I'm under pressure, underpaid, and working overtime. I mix a
bit. Here we go, back on the ground. I know this is round three. Nobody wants to get back on the ground, but you're gonna be proud of yourself when you do it. Gotta encourage yourself. And Mark, get set. Go. Let that little voice inside your head that's telling you to stop or telling you that your arms hurt.
let it be an encouraging voice saying, my arms hurt, I must be doing something right. My arms hurt, I'm getting better. Don't let it be a voice of, my arms hurt, I need to stop. Very good. Down that diamond push up. You need to take a break, shake out your hands, go for it. Don't make it a long one though. Down onto the ground for those back extensions. Remember, we're engaging everything here. Even if it's tiring, we're engaging it.
Even if you don't believe me, even on my darkest days.
I know the ground's comfy. Can't let yourself rest for too long. Up into a side plank. Squeeze all the way through. Keep yourself in a straight line. I encourage you that if you don't have a mirror at your house, you can set up your phone. Camera around to face you. You can check your form that way. Very good. Switch on over. Other side.
Flashes of doubt that grow into rage. Locked out the truth that keep your dreams at bay. Don't stand and wait for the time to come. Come on, come on, catch me, we got miles.
Rotate it all the way through.
We are alive, the skin is leaving these bones. Fire in the wind, we're burning.
Very good, into that crab walk position. Make sure you use those triceps, not just the shoulders. Adding that kick out.
We tear these curtains open, feel
5 seconds.
Swim to the surface, let our lungs ignite. Slip past the
and done. Take a break. Very good.
Come on, catch me.
We've only got one more.
We are alive, skin is leaving these bones. Fire in the wind, we're burning out of control.
Anything like me, you're checking the clock. You say, man, only 3 more minutes. I'm not sure if I can make it. But you're also checking the clock because you're like, oh, I got 3 more minutes. And I'm almost done. That's the voice we want to listen to. We need to listen to that upbeat voice. That voice that's telling us we can do it, that we've only got 3 more minutes. We can push ourselves. We can be strong. You got this. If I've got this in here all by myself, you've got this at home all by yourself. Here we go. Shoulder taps. We're on deck. On your mark. Get set. Here we go. These didn't seem that hard on round one. Now I'm feeling them. Are you feeling them? You aren't. Maybe you can make it a little harder. Bring those feet in. Maybe ask your hips to be a little more controlled. I don't know. Do whatever you need. Into those diamond push-ups. This is the one I'm feeling right here for sure. Seconds, and then we're into those back extensions. Very good. Down to the ground.
Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play.
focus. Learned our lessons through the tears. Made memories we knew would never fade.
Just gotta be focused. I know you're close to the ground. I know you're looking at your carpet. Say, man, I need to vacuum. Doesn't matter. You gotta get those distractions out. Got second half of this last round into a side plank here. Only a minute and a half left. Got it. Gotta just focus in on the task at hand. Push yourself right here. No distraction can get in your way. Very good. Switch it on over to the other side. This is my weaker side. I really gotta try. Really gotta push. You can do it at home too. Seconds. Here we go. Keep pushing. Only one move left after this. And switch it on over to those crab walk position. Tricep press with a kick out. Yeah, I'm kind of inventing a new dance move here. Trust me, if I can invent a dance move, you can definitely do it. Oh, I'm not a dancer. Wish I was. Looks pretty fun. When I dance, though, the only people having fun are the people watching me. Very good, and take a break. Well done. When you're ready, rejoin me on your feet. Our first cooldown move. It's gonna be like we're playing the guitar. So one arm's out, one arm's going over, but we're stopping in a T position. So it's a strum around stop. Make sure you're stopping on the dot right over here though. We don't wanna see this flying through. We'll get to that in a second. Very good, and switch over to the other side. Make sure we're doing a nice quality arc here. Keeping those shoulders back. Very good. Now what you're gonna do, same thing, but you're gonna allow it to come through. So get your hand up to here and I'll allow it just to fall through. I'm gonna go ahead and switch this over to something a little calmer. Not a ton calmer. But enough. Good. Switch over to that other side. Same thing. Up to the top. Pendulum down. Again, making sure we're still squeezing those shoulder blades. I know we're in a cool down, but that doesn't mean we can get sloppy. Very good. Okay. Now we're going to do what we started out with. Right here. Hands together in the front. We're just open. Good. Take a second. Shake out your hands. Shake out your arms. Move your neck around. Loosen that up. Palms up. Raise the roof again. I guess it's not really raise the roof. It's more of like get the crowd pumped up. But, you know, all the same. Good. Shake it out again. Okay, we're going back with it. Last move we're gonna do, just gonna pull your arm across. When you do this though, I want you to go ahead and take that neck, stretch it to the side, and then come back. You're just kind of tilting your head back and forth. As you tilt your head, make sure you're thinking about how relaxed it is. Make sure you're trying to relax that shoulder with it. Go ahead and switch over to the other side. Same thing, pull the arm across, then tilt the neck, head back and forth.
trying to loosen everything up. Allow that tension just to dissolve from the workout. Very good. Well, I appreciate those of you who are tuning in at home to the live stream. I appreciate everybody in the future that is going to be watching this. And always remember, like, comment, share, and subscribe. See you Wednesday.